year economics major student.
Hi, I'm Ashwin. I'm in third year mechanical.
Hello, I'm Rithima Vector. I am majoring in computer science and minoring in mathematics.
I'm Abhishek and I'm in second year computer science.
I'm Abhyuday Sharma and I'm a first year student of BTech CSE.
It's always a plan to do well, to perform well, to give your best. But it's never a plan to reach some particular number. It may be 9 or 10 or 8. That the number doesn't matter for me. What matters is to be able to give your best and not shirk.
If you plan that you're gonna get 10 SGPA, your schedule becomes very rigid, and nothing good ever came out of rigidity. So I would say, rather than, you know, planning for 10 SGPA and studying all the time in a very tight schedule, I'd say that make your schedule flexible, do other stuff, enjoy, you know.
I think I just got kind of lucky. I had a good GPA, but then 10 is chance at some level.
I was really surprised when I saw that I got the 10 CGPA, because in EVS I was getting around 7.
My mom is she thinks that I work too hard and I don't really enjoy much. So she was happy. She always is, but then she's more always concerned about if I'm happy in my life than my marks as such. And my dad, he knows that I want to go for a master's abroad, and a good CGPA would really help. And he knows that from the day one, I wanted at least once I wanted a perfect 10. So he was also really happy.
The parents were also very surprised, because I told them that I would get around 9, but I ended up getting a 10.
My parents, they believe me to be doing my best.
There is no mantra as such. What I believe in is that one should not take stress and just, you know, try to learn the subject instead of cramming it or just going for the marks. I think that's one way to go.
I wouldn't say I have a mantra for 10 SGPA. The trick is to go for quality rather than quantity. I think, yeah, that would summarize it.
I believe in three things. First, planning. Like, you should know where you are, where you are headed, and how to reach there. Second is perseverance, like stick to your plans. And third is frame of mind. Like, if you do your things with a positive frame of mind, your efficiency will be that much higher.
Regularly attending classes and trying not to miss is definitely the first step.
I went to all the classes, and I think that all the other students should also attend each and every class. As they're already inside the campus, so going to the class is not a very big problem.
You know, I did an experiment this time for taking notes. I used 3 different colored pens. One black, a red pen, and a blue. So, the headings were in black and the other parts were in blue, stuff like that. So, yeah, it became very visually provoking to me that it said to me that revise. So yeah, make your notes cleaner. They definitely help you while revising.
I think the best part about it is it's focused on the SGPA. Each new semester can be a fresh new start, and it is like a great motivation for you to achieve really great in that semester.
Yeah, haan, ye 3 saal mein to ye pehli baar ho raha hai.
Ah, yeah. So, are you feeling good that this happened?
Yeah, I'm getting 5,000 rupees.
What will you do with the money?
I've not decided yet.
Put it in a bank account. That's what I do whenever I get any cash prize.
I'm not sure what to do with that. I think my mother will take that. Yeah.
But I guess there's still a lot more to go. There's still a lot to do. There's still a lot to prove. To strive for. There are further challenges coming ahead. So looking forward.
I think that I, it is interesting that I have a 10 CGPA and a 10 semester GPA. I plan to do get 10 CGPAs in the future, but I don't know how much would I get.
Getting a 9 or a 10 GPA is not an achievement. It should not be. It should be an ongoing process. You should learn in class. And if you learn, I'm pretty sure there is no power in the world that can hold you from getting a 10 GPA.